Now, at 11 a.m., I change the value of orange to plum. Oracle writes down the new value in the redo, but the old value is still there in the real table. At 11.02 a.m., Oracle actually changes the value to plum in the table. At this time, Oracle puts the old value in the undo area. Why? Every transaction has a timestamp in it, and they may read multiple tables over a period of time. For example, there could be a query reading from these three tables starting at 11 a.m. and may take 30 minutes to finish. If the tables are huge, it may get to the second table at 11:15 to read it and to this third table at 11:20. By the time, these tables could have been modified. Let's assume that somebody has committed their modifications in table 2 at 11:10 a.m. and at 11:15 a.m. in the third table. Now, will the data be consistent if this query reads these new values? No. It has to get the data as it was when the query started. It has to fetch the data as it was at 11 a.m. But these two tables have data that are new. Where will it get the old data from? The answer is from undo section. Let's go back to this slide again. Data was modified at 11 a.m. The data got written into the table at 11.02 a.m. Now, I have a query that has been running since 10.50 a.m. After reading multiple tables, now it has come to read this table. It will read rows 1 and 2 without any issue. At row 3, Oracle's internal mechanism will tell that query that this value of plum is new and you need the old value as it was at 11 a.m. So it will fetch the old value from undo, which is orange. The result will look like this. This is just a simplification. Technically, Oracle writes the data into the real tables even if it is not committed. But those would be confusing as of now and are for advanced level courses. Thank you for watching this video.